Hello, my name is Sharif, and I'm continuing the series of tutorial videos we have for creating mobile workspaces to work in the Dynamics 365 for Operations mobile app. In the last video, we left off after having just created the All Sales Orders page, which we see on the right-hand side of the screen here, running on my Android device. In this video, we're going to show how we can enhance this experience by providing a sales orders details page, which is accessible when you tap on one of the particular sales orders in this list. Right now, tapping on a sales order in this list doesn't navigate you anywhere. So to begin that process, we're going to edit our existing sales order management workspace, which contains the All Sales Orders page. Now we see that All Sales Orders page is right here in the list of pages below. We're going to go ahead and edit that All Sales Orders page because this page contains the list that we want to provide a navigation to. So we'll select that page and click Edit. Then we'll select the list and we'll select its properties. All right, and we'll see inside of its properties, we're provided with some additional options. We can change the default size of the records that come down. Right now, I think by default, we pull down 50 records to the mobile device. You can increase this or decrease this. There are no technical limits in place by the framework, but of course the user storage on the user's mobile device could be limited. We'll go ahead and leave that at 50, the default here. We see that we have an option to change the style for the list. By default, it's set to the simple style, which is what we see on the right-hand side where the fields are stacked on top of each other. We'll go ahead and change that to a card style to spice things up a little bit. And the most important part here is adding the details page. We see we have two options. We can select an existing page or we can add a page. In this case, we don't have any existing pages that we can use as a details page. The only page we've designed so far is the All Sales Orders page. So we're going to go ahead and add that details page by clicking Add Page and then providing a name for it. There we go. So now we're taking back to the familiar page design experience. We saw a similar design experience when we first designed the All Sales Orders page. And we'll go through a very similar process for designing the Sales Order Details page. But we'll have to use a workaround in this case because the All Sales Orders form isn't designed with the mobile guidelines in mind. It's a form that was designed, of course, long before the mobile platform came into being. And what that means is that the Sales Order Details form is actually not a top-level form. You have to click on one of these sales orders in this list, wait for it to open. See, it takes a few seconds here. And there we go. And now we're at the sales order details. But there's no way to get to the sales order details from the menu. And there's no way to get there by searching through the forms. The only way to get there is by opening first the top level form, All Sales Orders, and then selecting a particular sales order to navigate to its details. Right? So this is important because we have to make sure that the mobile framework understands how to get access to this data. And what that means is we need to make sure we follow our best practices when we're designing this page. So as we discussed in the first video, we always want to make sure we start with a top level form. So we'll go ahead and select a top level form. It's going to be All Sales Orders in this case. And actually, before I open that form, do take note that Select Fields is not enabled. All right? And this is because the framework actually understands that since we're designing a details page, and this details page is going to be a details for a sales order, it's going to make sure that we open a form that has sales table as the master root data source. And of course, all sales orders has sales table as the master root data source. All right. And that master root data source sales table is the same data source that the grid is bound to we're seeing here inside of our mobile device. If we go to all sales orders, the grid we see here is bound to sales table, which is why the details page must also be using a form whose master root data source is bound to sales table. So select fields is now enabled again, and we'll give my Android device a chance to reconnect. Select fields is enabled because the master root data source from this form is sales table. And I've just opened the top level form. I haven't interacted with it. I haven't changed any state. I haven't edited any controls. I haven't expanded or collapsed any fast tabs. I want to make sure I let it open up in its initial state and perform no interactions on the form before clicking select fields. And that's important because we need to make sure that whatever interactions we take on the form, the mobile system is aware of so that it can use these actions to access that data. In this case, the most important action that the mobile system needs to be aware of is navigating to a sales order details. So in this case, I'm going to actually use sales order 768 because this sales order has some lines attached to it. I don't believe this most recent sales order has any sales lines. I'll go ahead and navigate to sales order 768. We'll give that form a second to open. So now, because I navigated through the sales order details while I was in the design system, the mobile framework is now aware of how to get to the sales order details page. So that's really important. I clicked select fields before I performed that navigation. And now everything works as it normally does. When I first designed the sales orders page, I saw these plus buttons appear beside each of the fields in the sales order list that were selectable. Now I'll just select the ones from the details page. So I'll start off by selecting the header we have there. I'll select the address, one of the receipt dates, this discount information, and now I'll select some of the lines. I want to include the item number, the product name. I think I want to include the quantity and the unit price, which is a little further down here. All right, so as we expect, each one of the fields that I've selected is now displayed in my field list. There we go. So there are no other actions I don't need to take on this form. I want to make sure that I don't perform any actions that would change the data on this form. I don't want to click new, I don't want to click delete, I don't want to add a line as a part of this design process. I want to make sure I don't click anything that would change the state of this data. And it's important because everything that I'm doing in this design process, the navigating to the sales order details form, the selecting of these fields, all of this information is being captured by the mobile system, by the mobile framework. And any actions I take as a part of designing this page are also going to be executed by the mobile framework when it attempts to fetch this data. So we want to make sure that fetching the data doesn't have any side effects like editing the data. That's really important. So I'm not going to execute any operations that would change the data. I'm just going to click the plus button beside the fields I want to select and then click done. There we go. So now my sales order details page has been designed. I have the fields here selected, and I had to use that workaround where I started from the top level form all sales orders because the sales order details form is itself not a top level form. So I go ahead and click back. This will take me back to the all sales orders page, right? And on this list now, if I check its properties, I should see that my sales order details page is selected as a details page. That's great. I'll go back one more step. This takes me back to the mobile workspace, and I'll see I have two pages now inside of my mobile workspace. I have all sales orders and sales order details. And in this case, sales order details is a nested page. You know, you can only get to the details by accessing an item from all sales orders. That's important noting it's a nested page. I'll go ahead and click done. I'm done designing my workspace for now. I'll go ahead and save and overwrite the previous version. There we go. It's already published. I'm running Platform Update 4, so I have the ability to unpublish or publish. In this case, the workspace is already published, which means the updated metadata is now available to my users. They simply need to come back to the workspace landing page and pull to refresh here. This will make sure that they get the latest metadata, which has that additional details page linked to the items in the all sales orders page. So we'll see that on my landing page, I don't see both pages appearing here. I don't see the all sales orders page and the sales order details page, and that's because the sales order details page requires context. It requires a record context, so you can't access it from the root level. All right, so we go ahead and say all sales orders. All right, two things have changed here. Number one, we see we have that card style that I changed on that list property. It looks a little fancier. We also see that each one of these items now has a navigation. On the right-hand side of the screen, you see that arrow pointing to the right, essentially meaning you can now navigate to an additional page to see the details for each one of the items in this list. There we go. And that goes all the way down the list. We're going to choose sales order 768. Because that has some lines on it and we want to see those lines show up since we did design those as well. I'll simply tap on the sales order. We're going to be taken to the details page now, and it's important to know what's going on in the background while it's loading this data. So what the mobile framework is doing is it's going out to the AOS, it's logging in, creating a session, a brand new session, using the user context here, which in my case is the administrator because I'm logged into the mobile app as the administrator. So it creates a new session as the administrator. It goes to that top level form, which is the all sales orders form. It'll get to this top level form, right? And once it's at this top level form, it's going to apply a filter. This is really important. It applies a filter in order to know exactly which record to open, right? So in this case, we open record 768. So what the mobile framework is actually doing behind the scenes is it's applying a filter to this page, similarly to what you would do over here in the filter pane. And it's saying filter down to whatever rec ID we happen to be using here. So it's not actually using the sales order number. It's using a rec ID behind the scenes. So it applies a filter, and I'll give you an equivalent one. I'll just go ahead and use the sales order to show you what that would look like. Where is our sales order? There we go. Which one of these? I'm going to see if it's the one that says option. So we begin with 768. I may have to change it to the other field. Nope, there we go. So that's essentially what the mobile framework has done. It opened this top level page first, because when we selected fields, we were already on this top level page. So the first thing it does is open that top level page. The second thing it does, and it does this automatically, it's not something we did when we were designing the page. The second thing it does is it applies a filter like this, right? So behind the scenes, the mobile framework will actually apply a filter based on the rec ID, not the sales order. So it'll apply a filter, and then exactly one record will be available in the grid. And then the mobile framework will then execute the remainder of the steps that I executed when I was designing the page. And that first step was to go ahead and navigate into the record. And since there's only one record here, it's going to navigate into that record. And then the mobile framework is going to copy the values from those various fields, the header, the address, the date, the discount, and the lines. It's going to copy the values there. And because the lines is in a grid, it's going to iterate over the items in that data source and copy those particular field values. And then it's going to pass that data down to the mobile device. And as I mentioned before, it doesn't just pass the data down. It also passes down the bindings and the schema information. So it passes down information like these fields are coming from the sales order. Some of these fields may be coming from the customer account, and these fields are coming from sales order lines, right? And there's a relationship between the sales order and its lines. So the relational schema is actually understood by the mobile device, so that when we're offline, we can create a line for the sales order, and it appears, you know, in the related entities like it should elsewhere inside of the mobile app. So that's all we wanted to share for this tutorial video. In the next one, we'll go into a bit of our data create and data edit scenarios, where we'll talk about how to create an action for a page.